Hey guys, Pastor Blake here. Hope you're having a great Christmas holiday, great Christmas vacation. Wanted to send you all a quick kind of video update, letting you know what we have going on these next few weeks, letting you know some changes, adjustments that we're doing within the ministry to get ready for this coming year. So most of you know that spring is our busiest time. Spring is when we grow the most. So everything we've been doing has been building up to this moment. And I just want to thank you guys so much for who you are and what you do. I just appreciate you. I appreciate your buy-in to this ministry. I appreciate the ownership that you guys are taking on and your passion that you have for these students. So thank you for that. What we're looking to do for a kickoff meeting is kind of jump onto the One Conference. It's a conference that we're hosting here at the church January 9th and 10th. That's a Friday night and a half day Saturday. It's 100% free. I'm not going to make it mandatory, but I would love for as many of you guys who want to come and can come to attend it. It's all going to be about unity and doing things together in a team, doing things together in a ministry. And I think it's crucial for us as we continue to grow to kind of have some more training on this. So again, it's not mandatory. I would highly appreciate it if you can make both that Friday night and that Saturday morning. What we are going to do though is have a mandatory meeting right after that conference, a quick lunch, quick coffee, maybe about an hour, hour and a half, and break into our teams and talk about what's going on this upcoming year. So that's going to be January 9th and 10th, and then our mandatory meeting will be on the 10th. Just to kind of rev us up and get excited for what's going on. Now, as many of you know, on the 7th, our first service back, we're doing a small group mixer. And what this is we're going to do a three-song worship set. We're going to have a really short video-based teaching, and then we're going to break into small groups all across the church so that we can have as much face time with our students as we can. Now, in order to accomplish this, we're going to break you guys into your 7th and 8th grade house, 9th and 10th grade house, 11th and 12th grade house, and comfort house. We'll break the students up by those demographics, and then we're going to try to get it even smaller than that and try to have each leader have their own group of students. Based off of some of the surveys that we've been doing, we're starting to see that many of you guys, if you're underutilized in your groups because there's two leaders to 10 or 6 students. And so what we're trying to do is figure out how do we kind of maybe break those up. And we're thinking through the process of even multiplying our houses and having two guy leaders, two girl leaders, and the kind of a core house leader within the house. So it'd be four groups, one leader each, but it'll give you guys more face time, more intimacy, more connect time with those students. So this is a thinking cap, but I want to throw it out to you guys. Email me some questions, feedbacks. I've already been talking to a few of you these last few weeks and these last kind of few small groups to see what you think. And that's the way we're leaning right now. But I want to kind of hear your thoughts. I know it's scary for some of you because you'll kind of be on your own. But the reality of it is you guys are ready to do this. That it's just really just engaging and talking to students. That's all they want. They just want people to hear from them and acknowledge them. So just want to let you know that's what's going on with the mixer on the 7th. Small groups start back up the night of the 11th. We'll have our training on the 9th and 10th. And then we have our senior trip coming up the end of January. We're going to be looking to do Super Bowl parties within our small groups at the end of the month as well. So just want to let you guys know I appreciate who you are. I appreciate what you're doing. We're going to really try to emphasize and grow our teams this coming semester, really begin to empower those team leads to take ownership, really to begin to challenge you guys to take ownership. How can we get better at what we're doing? We're going back into the student lounge. We're going to have a pre-service connect from that 6:30 to 7 window where people will go into the garage. They'll engage, connect. We have kind of some fun things we're going to do to really push that vision of finding the one, to empower our students to find the one. And then we're going to have a student lounge on the back end where we as leaders can kind of engage with new faces, invite them into our small groups, vision cast what we're about as a ministry, and then head into kind of building those relationships. This coming January, we're going to be doing a series called I Believe, and it's about the Apostles' Creed, and we're going to do a five-week series breaking down the five kind of core chunks of the Apostles' Creed. We're looking at doing a friend series again, but this one is going to be about compassion, love your neighbor as yourself, and kind of breaking down what does it look like to have compassion and to care about the people around you, care for yourself, have relationships. We're going to be doing a three-week series on pride, grace, and faith. Jen Long might be coming and speaking to us about pride. She has a phenomenal message that she gave at Women's Bible Study last semester. So we're kind of excited about everything that's going on. Also want to put on the calendar for you guys, Desperation, July 8th. So that Tuesday through that Sunday, we're going to Desperation. As you guys know, leaders, specifically small group leaders, this is something that we want you to be at. You will be in your group with your students at the hotel doing life with them. So begin to mark your calendars for that. The cost is going to be about the same as we did last year for you guys. $100 deposit. We'll cover the rest of it. And we'll go from there. So love you guys. Appreciate what you're doing. Also want to let you know we are finalizing a Desperation Tour conference in April, April 18th and 19th here on our campus, or the Friday, Saturday here on our campus. That's going to be a big push for us this year. And I also want to let you know we're looking to find some people to partner with us to help, one, with a couple things with that conference. So we're looking for three or four project managers who want to rally along us and support that conference. We're also looking for some people who want to help with the fundraising for Desperation. It tends to be a pretty tedious event, not as much as hard work, but it takes time. So we're going to be doing our car wash-a-thon again. We're going to be moving and driving our students to get pledges again. It works amazing. The Billingsley brothers got like $5,000 last year out of it. We're going to have a couple work days on campus. So we're looking for someone who's kind of administrative-minded, who can help kind of facilitate and push and empower and speak to those things for us. So if you're interested in that and you know someone who'd be amazing, please let me know. But I just want to say from Devin and I appreciate you guys so much. I'm excited. Let us know how we can support you. Thank you for all that you do. Thank you for supporting 1910. And I'll see you guys at the beginning of the year.